And I understand where your question is coming from. Because of what we are accustomed to. If you look at our statement and read through our statement, we have said that we want to change the matrix of how political engagements and negotiations are done in this country. So understanding us from that point, that it is not business as usual, because it is usual business to sit here as politicians and negotiate with another political leader for political position and for politics' sake, and what will be politically expedient to the candidate and even to us as political leaders. It is that matrix of engagement that we are saying we want to change. We want to put the aspirations and the needs of the people ahead of everything else. And for those of us, if you look at our statement, we have begun by enumerating the problems that our people are living with today. Most of them stemming on undemocratic governance of the country and also the meltdown, economic meltdown. And that's why we said we want to do a two-part negotiation. One that will begin with economic revival. Once we agree on the economic revival, then we can move to the next phase, which is the political interest. Who fits in? Is it person A, person B? To push through the implementation of that economic revival agenda. Therefore, but if we begin by discussing like the others on who should take what position under what system of government, we get it wrong. And that's where we say, as the people's representatives, we carry the aspirations and the needs of the people ahead of everything else, ahead of our own political interest. I know we have been accused since 2017, some of us since 2013, that we work with the deputy president because we want that and this and that position. Those will come later once we settle on agenda number A.
Bandini Nyoro has said it is very dependent on who is on the chair. That's when he says Ziongu Ziongu.
Of course, it is dependent, and Moses Kuria has put it very well. I did listen to one of the presidential candidates being asked on one of your TV stations, what will be your agenda or what is your plan in your first 100 days in office? And he replied by saying, in the first 100 years, and I can forgive him for that being a slip of the tongue, that your people are tired. Maybe you can ask me that question in the next interview. What is that to tell you, my friend? Is that this is a candidate who has no plan. We are therefore engaging with a candidate whom the people we represent have already identified as a candidate who has a vision, who has a plan, and who knows what he wants to do for this country. He's now asked to come and fit into that.
The last question. In your statement, you also say that you want to take the country back to where Kibaki put it. Remember, you were also in government between 2013 and 2017, and you credited the development of this country into the good relationship that you had. Are you also blocking that in saying that you want to go back into the Kibaki era?
No. I think we have been very clear, and I think if you listen to the candidate, Deputy President William Ruto, in his citizen interview last week, he did enumerate where we came from in 2013. That was just to carry on with the good work that President Mwai Kibaki had established up to 2012, 2013. We did well to carry on with that work up to 2017. Then Handshake happened, and we veered off that agenda. And it is that agenda that you see, we are saying, other than banning our people's merchandise in Nyamakema, those people expected that immediately after the 2017 elections, because we had promised under the Big Four agenda, a manufacturing agenda, that they had learnings from the countries we're importing goods from, we would transition them from importing into cottage industries and onward to the Naivasha Industrial Park. Are we still on that agenda? We lost track. We went to Handshake and BBI and changing the constitution. We now want to engage along where the trajectory we had taken. And that's why we said we want to begin from the trajectory that Mwai Kibaki left. We are not saying that the first time the government never did anything. They did well up to a certain point, then veered off the tracks. We want to come back to the tracks, push on with the agenda that we had, the trajectory that we had, that would ensure there's job creation, there's business support, there's enterprise development and free enterprise, so that we end the era of monopolies and cartels.